So this is the PTO end of the driveline. The shield itself is in pretty bad shape, especially on this end. Probably should have been replaced some time ago. So that's my objective anyway, to put a new shield on the driveline today. So the snowblower end of the shield mechanism, much better shape than the other side. So this is the PTO end of the driveline shield, matching up the driveline there. So to move back the bell portion, just insert the two blade screwdrivers, apply some leverage, and pull back the carriage cam. That should do it.
Comes off of that metal ring with the groove in it and the matching ring. So I'm going to cut off some material here. While I have it on the bench here, I have to put in a new shear pin right here. I have to grease up two grease nipples there. I have to get grease in this groove right here. Over like that. It's a grease nipple here as well. Right here. You can see the black clip right there, the white clip right here. Push forward, a bit of force here. There we go. This is the only shear pin that has failed. There's two total, one up here in the PTO end and another on the snowblower itself. This is the only one that has failed for me so far. Two parts that separate when the shear pin goes. The bolt, shear pin bolt goes through here.
So now we have to clean up and grease the snowblower end of the driveline.
Do it. I'll put this on now. I'll spread it out later. There we go. So take this ring off. And we line up the holes with the tabs as before. Make sure they all actually get into place. Leave that there. Look, be okay. I think I might have enough grease on here, but this is the grease nipple right there, right here, so I'm doing okay. Get it up, lined up. Get the feel for it. Snap it in place. So that's good. It's good to go. There we go. So I got it right that time. So it was like that. Slides up like that. Adjusts as required. This is ready to go into the tractor PTO right here. So the driveline shield extension that I made from vinyl siding pretty well covers up the entire universal joint that was exposed by perhaps 2 inches or so. Never was comfortable with that, so now it should be okay. The other end is fine, it's protected by this hinge cover here.